In this question, you have a horrific expression involving square roots and x and that sort of thing, and it's equal to 3, and you have to find out what x is. Well, this horrible expression is actually built up out of a single easy function. Function of x is the square root of x plus 1. The point being that if you apply f 3 times, you get the disgraceful expression given in the question. So f of f of x is 3, and you want to find out what x is. Well, you're given a variety of possible answers, and you could plug them in, but there's an easier way. What you could do is to notice that you can undo the work of this function. If I told you the value of the square root of x plus 1, you could work out x. And how would you do that? Well, you would take the square root of x plus 1, you subtract 1 from it to give you the square root of x, and then you square it and you'd recover x. So what that means is it's interesting to consider the function g, g of y, say, where you subtract 1 from y and then you square it. This function is designed so that if you first apply f to anything and then apply g, what happens is you get x back. So putting a g in front of an f makes them both disappear. So I take this equation and I apply g to both sides. On the right-hand side, you've just got g of 3. On the left-hand side, you've got g of f of f of f of x. But at the beginning, you've got g of f of stuff. And so you can just forget that g of f. And we're left with this fact. Now you apply g to both sides again, and this will make this f disappear, and then apply g to both sides again, and that will make the final f disappear. And we'll have so, this is a formula for our answer. Remembering that g of something is obtained by subtract 1 and then square, g of 3 is 4. So that's 3 minus 1 is 2, square it, you get 4. Now, do it again. We take 4, we subtract 1 and square, we get 9. And finally, g of 9, we subtract 1 and square, we get the answer 64. So that's the correct answer.